हरि ओम वेलकम बैक टू शेवेदी चैनल एंड हैप्पी मंडे एवरीबॉडी एंड व्हाई एम आई डूइंग दिस वीडियो बिकॉज सो फार इन एनी ऑफ द वीडियोस इंक्लूडिंग द लॉन्च वीडियो आई डिडंट रियली टॉक अबाउट द पीपल बिहाइंड दिस चैनल बिकॉज आई वांटेड द कंटेंट्स ऑफ दिस चैनल टू स्पीक फॉर देमसेल्व्स बट लेटर आई फेल्ट मे बी आई शुड यू नो एट लीस्ट इवन इफ हैव एनी क्वेरीज लाइक या समबडी इज डूइंग दीज वीडियोस ऑन yoga and spirituality bhagavad gita and what qualification do they have really to talk about these things that's a very valid question right before you employ anybody in your company or when you're interviewing somebody you will look at their resume or certification they have in that field so that's why I thought I will just do a quick intro video my name is Manjula Hosadurga this is a name actually, if I ask who am I, right? If you ask who you are, I can just say like I'm a human being. I mean, just jokes apart. This is a very who am I, right? That's a deep philosophical question. I want to keep this particular video lighthearted. Who am I? The Upanishadic thing that we'll take up later in one of the spirituality related videos. My name is Manjula. And I play different roles, mother, wife, and a daughter, and a daughter-in-law, and friend, and a project manager, and a blogger. I have a blog site, and then YouTuber now. Okay, and so these are the different roles I've been playing. And coming to my training, actually, I have a bachelor's degree in software engineering. So the typical IT background, and I've been working in the software IT field for the past over 20 years. So that is the actual educational background I have and the experience I have in the field of IT domain. And coming to yoga and spirituality, right? Because that is some of the main videos I'm doing on this channel. My journey with yoga started maybe 4 to 5 years back. And I have a yoga certification, yoga instructor certification from a renowned yoga university called SVSA. It's Sri Vivekananda Yoga Anusandhana Samsthana, which is a world-renowned yoga university based in Bengaluru, India. Okay, and that is where I completed the certification and currently pursuing a master's degree in yoga therapy from the same university. I am currently pursuing my final semester project, so I'm working on my dissertation now. So that is the experience I have in the yoga field. Now coming to the Bhagavad Gita and other spiritual things, when actually I entered the field of yoga, I had the spiritual and religious upbringing because my parents gave me that solid foundation. And then the schools I went to also had given me that very good foundation in those subjects and along with the usual subjects we all learn from our schools, be it math, science and languages and social science and everything else. And when we come to the yoga field, right, then you can ask like how did I pick up Bhagavad Gita and spiritual things? The inclination was there in my mind always towards those subjects. But when I entered the field of yoga, how did I get introduced to those subjects or how did I get some experience? Because when you pick up any subject, you cannot learn everything by practice. Some theoretical background you have to have. That foundation is needed. For example, in the IT field, before you start programming in any language, you have to know, what is the syntax of that language, and what's the language construct and how do you communicate maybe with the user interface and the database. Just like that, here also we need to have a theoretical background. Then you can put that into practice. So because people, when we say yoga, they think it's like asanas. So they say, okay, then how is yoga means, okay, asanas, I'm into calisthenics and I'm into aerobics and so they think they equate yoga to any other physical exercise, which is a for a novice in the field of yoga, that's the understanding everybody has. But if you are into the field of yoga, you know that yoga is not just asanas, just one part of it, and there is something more to it. So which can actually have a very life-changing experience if you really take it up. So when we entered the yoga, path of yoga, when I was doing that instructor certification, and when I was doing MSc, so we got introduced to Bhagavad Gita and also Vedas, Upanishads as part of our curriculum. So, and I was very influenced by all the teachers who are in that university, because they are not only teaching but they are living those things. Actually, you are like teaching by example. So that is what I felt. And as I mentioned in my one of the launch videos, I believe, my immediate guru, Shripurna Roy madam, she is the one who introduced us to Bhagavad Gita memorization and chanting. And so that is how I got introduced to Bhagavad Gita. So I am in the in constant recitation on a daily basis. It's kind of my part of my spiritual hour, okay, every day. So that is the thing I have experience I have in the field of Bhagavad Gita and spirituality. And then I will be covering some fun aspects also, maybe cooking, gardening. What experience do I have? It's because as a mother and a wife and as a householder, I had to cook. So far, my family is not complaining about the dishes I cook. So I think I have some experience there. And we have a garden, and I won't call myself a green thumb, but I like plants, all varieties of plants and flowers. So I have developed liking, and at least I can maintain the plants in a healthy condition. So we can do that, and maybe some fun videos, because humor is very important in everybody's life to keep us going. So that said, that's the intro about myself and the content. Some of you have already subscribed to the channel, which is very encouraging, and I feel it's a very fulfilling thing, because whatever I have learned, I'm imparting that and sharing that knowledge with you guys, with all of you viewers. It is like, because I think it's like a giving it back to the society, because these are some of the core concepts or the values that we can inculcate in our lives. And you can say that, how Bhagavad Gita is going to help us, how yoga is going to help us. It is nothing to do with any of the regional thing or any caste. It actually, I consider Bhagavad Gita as a life guide, because the only thing that is holding back people is just the language. People say, okay, it's in Sanskrit language, we don't understand. Yes, granted, it's not a language that we use for daily communication, but there are so many translations and commentaries available. If you are really interested, we can definitely pick up a book and learn. And it is not just some hymns or scriptures that you learn and do. It's not stamped to any particular religion per se. It is all about, it gives you guidelines how to lead life and how you can tackle different types of situations in your life. That's why I call it the ultimate guide of life. So, and when we can pick up any language like French or Spanish or any, in India itself we have so many different languages, right? When we can pick up those languages, why can't we do the same if it is going to help us, right? But this is very subjective, and just because I experienced it, I'm not going to put that my experience on you and say you have to learn. It's not like that. It is very subjective. You will understand only if you have faith in it and inculcate those values in you. And I hope whatever things that are being covered on this channel is going to help all of you in some way or the other. So that is the intent behind it. And I really appreciate those who have already subscribed and provided your valuable input. And I'm going to incorporate all those things in the upcoming videos. And thank you so much for your time. And as always, Sarve Janaha Sukhino Bhavantu. Keep smiling always.